As I unboxed my new laptop this week, it got me thinking, what's the best laptop for data science in 2021? Let's talk about it. Whether you've just started your first data science project or job, there's always the question of what laptop or computer to get. It's hard not to get confused with the plethora of options out there. When you think of computers for data science, you might be tempted to think of chunky gaming laptops with NVIDIA GPUs, or you might even think of custom-built computers. But surprisingly, the machine I've been using for the last 4.5 years as a data scientist has been the MacBook Pro. I've used both the 13-inch version and the 15-inch versions. It ticks all the boxes for what you might need out of a data science computer. We'll get to why I recommend it, but first let's talk more generally about the basic needs of a data science computer. So it'll be useful to you even if you're not looking to buy a MacBook Pro, because obviously there's a lot more choices when it comes to laptops for data science. So in terms of basic requirements for data science laptops, they fit in 4 categories: RAM, CPU, storage, and GPUs. So let's talk about RAM first off. Decent amount of RAM helps with smooth operation of your computer and help with loading in large data sets that you might need for data wrangling, cleaning, and analysis. Obviously, when it comes to loading in datasets, there are programmatic ways that you can minimize the memory uses, such as using chunking in Pandas data frame. But it's always good to have a good amount of RAM on your laptop, as it'll make sure that your computer doesn't chug when it's running multiple parallel apps. At a minimum, I would recommend 16 GB, but the laptop I just recently got, I made sure to have 32 GB on it, because that's definitely something I don't want to be compromising on. Depending on the laptop, it can be costly to upgrade RAM, so definitely pick an option that works for you. Let's talk about CPU. So as a minimum, I would recommend 4 cores, as that allows you to undertake parallel workflows, which will speed up the running of your code. And that's definitely something very useful. I've previously owned a dual core MacBook Pro, and it really chugged when you had lots of apps running. These days, many high-end processors have 6 core or 8 core, which will be more than enough for majority of your needs. The Intel processors packaged with MacBook Pros are generally quite good from my experience. I don't really know how the M1 performs other than the reviews I've seen, but I definitely opted not to get the M1 laptop, as I'm not too sure about the compatibility with various coding tools. I know a while back it didn't quite work so well with Docker, so I'll definitely be waiting to see what happens with the M1 chips before I opt in to buy an M1 laptop. And I've also heard very good things about the AMD Ryzen processor for data science purposes. Definitely make sure to look at them. If you're enjoying the video so far, then consider subscribing. I make weekly videos to demystify the land of data science. Next up, let's talk about storage. Definitely make sure to get a laptop with SSD drives. I mean, SSD drives are generally standard these days, so I would definitely opt for a minimum of 256 GB. I know I like to definitely upgrade that to 512 GB, but that's not really necessary. And if you need extra storage, I would recommend SSD external drives. I bought this 1 TB SanDisk SSD a couple of months ago, and it's been running great. Accessing files on your external SSD drive is just as fast as accessing them on your computer. So that's definitely very useful when I'm saving my video editing files on there. Finally, let's talk about GPUs. So as you might already know, GPUs are very commonly used in machine learning, especially for deep learning algorithms. But if you're just starting out, getting a CPU on your laptop is not really a necessity. There's lots of online tools out there, such as Google Lab and Kaggle Notebooks, which will allow you access to free GPUs. And that'll be more than enough when you're trying out a couple of new data science projects. And most commercial companies out there that are doing ML in a serious fashion will never really have you training algorithms on your local machine, as it'll all be done on cloud instances or on-prem computers, which are basically custom-built computers that sit in the office or in some data center that's open for use by the data science team. On the other hand, if you are a serious ML user, then check out some of these laptops that I found. Or better yet, you can look at custom-built computers, because that way at least you can upgrade the hardware with time. While I haven't really done this before, I recently did find a Medium article by Jeff Chen, an AI engineer that built his own computer for machine learning for under $3,000. So I'll leave a link to the post below, so definitely check that out. That post is from the end of 2019, so a lot has changed since then, so be sure to find more recent resources if you're considering custom building your own computer. Now that we've done a run through of the basics, let's talk about why I use the MacBook Pro as a professional data scientist. And most of the developers and data scientists that I worked with also use the same machine, as all of our model-related accelerated work, aka GPU intensive work, was always done in cloud instances or on-prem machine. There's a couple of advantages to using a MacBook Pro. So the first is that it's built on macOS, which is a Unix-based operating system, which provides a developer-friendly environment as it's extremely flexible, stable, and secure. And the command line environment on the macOS is very similar to the environment that's running on a lot of these web servers. So it's really helpful to be working on a machine that closely emulates your production environment. The second reason is the build quality and reliabilities. Due to the high build quality of the MacBook Pros, they can easily last you 4 to 5 years. As a matter of fact, the MacBook Pro I purchased in 2013 still runs fine to this day, albeit a bit slow due to the outdated nature of the hardware. The third reason is good cross-OS compatibility, so it's very easy to run Windows or Linux on your MacBook. The same can't be said for running macOS on Windows or Linux. So it's really helpful to have all of the different environments if you're doing things like iOS app development or Android development or Windows app development. So it's quite flexible with how you use macOS. And the final reason is user experience. You'll definitely know if you've used one of the Apple products like an iPhone or a MacBook that Apple is very big on providing a great user experience. And it's important to highlight that you can get all the benefits I just described using a Linux machine. But I've personally found Linux machines to be very finicky to configure, especially when it comes to dealing with different types of issues related to driver installations. So consequently, I do find the UI better to navigate on macOS. Additionally, I think MacBook Pros are better all-around laptops because, let's be honest, you won't just be using the MacBook for data science and you want it to be a great machine for things like internet browsing or running any type of app that's available on Windows. But in saying that, if you are considering a Linux machine for data science, I'd really suggest looking at the HP ZBook Studio G7. A couple of my coworkers have it and they seem pretty happy with it. If you've got money to burn, I would recommend getting the MacBook Pro 16-inch with the 6-core Intel processor and 32GB RAM. This is very similar to the specs of the laptop I've been using for the last 3 years. Otherwise, you can also opt for MacBook Pro 13-inch, but it all really depends on to what extent you intend on pushing your laptop. And at the end of the day, buy whatever machine you can afford, whilst keeping in mind the basic requirements that are discussed earlier, and it should be more than enough if you're just getting started. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.